the NewsX Sunday Garden Roundtable. There have been a host of judgments recently by the Supreme Court on various aspects of our lives, whether it is on Aadhaar, on Section 377, on adultery, and also on whether women should be allowed in a religious temple like Sabarimalai or not. Some have been welcomed, but others are also now questioning the role of the court. Are we now entering into an era of judicial activism? And if so, whose fault is it? Joining me now to discuss this on the roundtable is Sudhanshu Mittal, leader BJP. We have also Mr. Dinesh Trivedi, he's an MP from the Trinamool Congress. We have Tathagata Satpathy, he's an MP from the Biju Janata Dal. And Mr. KTS Tulsi, he's a member of the Rajya Sabha and of course a senior advocate also. Tulsi Saab, the ball is really in your court. I mean, the fact is that, you know, we've seen a host of judgments. Some have been welcomed. I think the Aadhaar judgment especially has been welcomed. But other judgments have, you know, questioned the rights of courts, whether they should be, you know, passing judgments on issues like this.
No, so far as the present judgments, the judgments that you mentioned are concerned, they are proper adjudicatory function of the court. The court has to decide the constitutional validity of a particular offence, penal offence, or various other aspects, whether somebody has a fundamental right to go and pray in a temple or not. But there are many other instances, for example, which building is to be demolished will be decided not by the executive, not by the municipal corporation, but by the court. And how does the court decide? So the court appoints its own members of the empowered committee. They will find out, they will then make an order. You see, there is a great amount of danger.
And there's no appeal.
Yes, Supreme Court, there's
Supreme
no appeal.
Supreme Court was, according to me, never meant for all this. The core function is adjudication. The specially petitions which have come, they have to be decided. Now, it is often said that what do we do if the executive doesn't do its work? What do we do if the legislature doesn't do its work?
Fair enough.
Do we do if judiciary doesn't do its work?
I agree with you.
There are 3.5 crore cases pending. Why are they pending? The judiciary must devote exclusively to the disposal of these cases. After that, if there is spare time available, one can think about it. Besides, second point is that I am really a believer in the American proverb that the courts do not enter the political thicket. There's no need for the courts to, if they want long time admiration of the people of that country, it's not necessary for the courts to enter political thicket. This is a different ball game altogether. So if the courts were to concentrate, the Supreme Court itself has said that there are so many unworthy causes, corporate wars which are fought in the court in the name of PIL. There are service rivalries which are played on in the course of PIL. There are many other vested interests which try and take advantage of this. I really think that it's time for the court to review its policy and see as to whether they should confine themselves to adjudicatory function at least for some time.
Okay.
I would really compliment Tulsi ji. Very rarely has somebody, and more so a lawyer, shown courage to speak out his mind so unequivocally and so clearly. There's this sher which I always say ki ye zabr bhi dekha hai tareekh ki nazron ne, lamhon ne kata ki thi sadiyon ne saza paayi. When you breach the four walls of what you say is the constitution and the separation of powers, it may be with the noblest of intent. But what can it degenerate into? You can't even imagine. The breaching becomes a precedence for disastrous things to happen. People have not articulated out of fear a few things, which I would take this opportunity. The classical example of the 2G. case. The Supreme Court concluded mala fide, and thus not only did it cancel all the licenses granted, it constituted its own SIT, monitored the functioning of the SIT monitored the prosecution to the extent that it also appointed the special public prosecutor for the same, debarred anybody else to interfere in the matter. Now, can you imagine what did it take to demolish the majesty, the authority and the confidence on Supreme Court? A judge of the level of a district judge. He demolishes all what was monitored by the Supreme Court and then passes strictures on the assumption of mala fide, on the competence of the public prosecutor, everything. Now that should be the point where Supreme Court must introspect. What is it exposing itself to? It can't be the judge, jury and the prosecutor itself. No. He said adjudication, the other role which was very critical was the interpretation. There is a legislation and there is a legislative intent. So legislations had to be interpreted in its legislative intent. If there is inadequacy of legislation, then the other instruments of the Constitution, mainly the legislative bodies, must do their work.
But they cannot take over the roles.
Okay. But Mittal Sahib, Tulsi, the fact is, Supreme Court doesn't take things on their own.
Yes.
Yadi aap Supreme Court ka darwaja khatkhataate hain, and if some citizen who has the legal right to approach the Honorable Supreme Court, and if it is in the interest of public, then Supreme Court...
Not even 1% cases that are filed are entertained. दरवाजा खटखटाने से कोई मजबूरी नहीं हो जाती
है वही हम कह रहे हैं
दरवाजा दैट इज व्हाई किसी में भी खटखटा दे
दैट इज व्हाई आई एम क्वालीफाइंग दैट्स व्हाई आई एम क्वालीफाइंग दैट आई हैव नॉट कंप्लीटेड कि आपने दरवाजा खटखटाया एंड सुप्रीम कोर्ट इज कन्विंस्ड दैट दिस इन्वॉल्व्स अ कॉमन सिटीजंस इंटरेस्ट लॉ एंड ऑर्डर इफ समबडी इज सपोज्ड टू माइंड द लॉ एंड ऑर्डर एंड दैट अथॉरिटी हैज नॉट डन इट
The Aadhaar.
If you look at even for example Aadhaar, now Aadhaar, whatever the government was going to do was beyond their brief.
And this is where they have not altered anything.
No, they have altered. I tell you what they have altered.
Worse.
No, I think what we are doing, we are not trying to dissect the judgment. All we are trying to say that somebody felt aggrieved, and till today I do not have Aadhaar because if you say that Aadhaar has to be linked with your...
But Aadhaar is not activism.
No, I'm just telling you. We're not discussing
that. Aadhaar is also something bad for society. I also do not have
Aadhaar. So where do you draw a line?
Why am I compelled now?
That is why.
In a democracy.
That is why.
Supreme Court compel me?
That is why whenever a citizen feels aggrieved and in their considered judgment, if the Honorable Supreme Court judges feel that this is a litigation good enough for the concern of a common citizen who cannot approach the court. So I think it is not only, we have to introspect ourselves also, that why so many cases are going to Supreme Court.
While talking about the Supreme Court of India, all of us will very clearly remember, there was this lady, I'm not naming any names, whose tapes were exposed by two magazines. Open or closed and inward look. And these two magazines came up with two weekends, they came out with excerpts from that tapes.
Conversation.
Then one very big industrialist goes to Supreme Court. I have the exact dates. I have the copies of the petitions on a Monday. The Supreme Court has a hearing on Wednesday. And on Friday, it says that you cannot publish anything further on these tapes. And promptly on that very Saturday, both those two magazines came out with 6 pages, 7 pages of more transcripts of those pages. Now, what my point is, that is the Supreme Court even bothered to protect its own credibility, its own respect in the eyes of the people? And as you talked about Aadhaar, which lobby was entitled to give the feedback on Aadhaar? It's the same Bangalore IT mafia that was asked to do it. The same people who want to make a mess, make a business, a commercial venture out of Aadhaar with all the database. Why should it say that you are forced to link your PAN with your Aadhaar now? Yeah. How does it matter if my bank account or my phone is not linked? Because my bank account and my phone are linked to my PAN. If you go deeper into it, you will see the Supreme Court is playing games with the people, which I feel is objectionable.
Instead of getting to specifics, I just want to make a point. You see, this argument...
But specifics
that,
help.
I'll qualify that. This argument that when the executive fails and approaches a court, what should the courts do?
Yes.
When the courts fail, and if people approach the executive, what should the executive do? When dispensation of justice becomes a distant dream with the kind of pendency of cases there are, you know, alternate remedies was so prevalent in commercial transactions because commercial jurisprudence was never effective. If I have to receive money in 15 years, there is nothing going to happen. What did I do? I went to all the thugs and said, "Mujhse paise le lijiye, karwa lijiye." Would then you make out a case that because judiciary is failing, then these thugs are right in doing it?
What? Or Mittal sir, what did you say? 15 lakhs or 15 years?
15 years.
Oh, I thought you were giving me the 15 lakhs that your party promised. I never got that somehow.
Yeah, should you go to court or should you go to the executive?
I thought we were on a more serious debate.
Oh,
and
I'm so
and
sorry.
If we're going to make light of this debate, you're most welcome to
no,
do
please,
it.
Please,
no, it's
please.
A no, serious promise.
I will compliment Priya and everybody because this is a debate which nobody would dare to get into.
Absolutely.
The fear, psychosis.
Compliment has to go to my panel then.
The fear that you will be hauled for contempt is anti-democracy.
Just for last,
as I said, can we in separation of powers allow other institutions to take over the authority or the functioning merely because one institution has failed? Because if you start doing it, as I said, lamho ne khata ki thi, sadiyon ne saza pai. If you start doing it, where would it end? Where would it stop? The noblest of intentions will degenerate in anarchy.
Okay,
don't. The constitutional four walls are sacrosanct. Inadequacies can be addressed through public debates. Please point it out.
There are no public debates that take
place. Even if
in
no
India,
public debates, let us not look at short-term solutions.
You remember Vajpayee Ji's time very well. After the Godhra riots, he said, let there be a public debate. Neither did the government, nor any NGO, nor any media. Nobody was bothered. It just went, hung fire.
About 15 years,
we know
the debate continued.
What history taught us, and now we are living that. So that
Godhra
is.
Godhra debate went on for 15 years.
Basically, let's agree one thing.
Hmm.
And a burning example is Ayodhya.
Yes.
Right? When, after so many years, if the political arena has not been able to sit together, convince or get convinced or find out a formula, if nothing has happened, then obviously they have pushed the matter to the Supreme
Court. That's fair, right? It's
because
adjudication.
They did not want to decide a case.
No, it is adjudication, and that's
Court
what
says,
Supreme Court is meant for.
If Supreme Court says that, no, I cannot take this case, then where are we? Then it's anarchy.
In fact, that's what
there
Supreme
has
Court
to
said.
Be, there has to be
they should
a
come
safety
up and
valve.
Say,
in fact,
there should be a safety valve when you talked about where else should we go. So, maybe Tulsi Sahib happened to this.
You see, I believe that the Privy Council was very clear about the jurisdiction of the courts and the jurisdiction of the police. And they said that we will never interfere in the police. And this court, right up to the case of Simranjit Singh Mann, said that even if there are a million questions of law to be gone into, they will be gone into only when the person concerned approaches the court. You see, if the court, if the investigation is going to begin with the Supreme Court, what is going to happen to the rest of the infrastructure of judiciary? Why can the magistrate not be approached first?
Mm.
It is a court of last resort. We make it into a court of the first resort.
So you have lost faith in institutions.
Then we need to build our institutions.
We have lost faith in other institutions.
Absolutely. And the Supreme Court is fast on that same track where people will lose confidence.
Probably, I don't know. I hope not.
That is the reason why it is time to sit down and reassess the direction in which governance is going.
Who will do it?
All of us, sir.
If
the polity is responsible, so is the executive and so is the judiciary.
Hmm.
Because if these are the three pillars, transgressing into someone else's area is always very pleasuresome. May not be legal and may not be desirable.
But fun.
As I said, it's always fun, yeah. But not be legal, not desirable also.
Are we still talking about Supreme Court over here? I don't know.
We are talking about transgressing into other areas.
Okay, on that note, we are also transgressing into a break. So we're going to take a short break, but come back. Stay with us. This is getting interesting. Hello and welcome back to the NewsDesk Sunday Guardian Roundtable. We are here discussing the role of the court. Are we entering into an era of judicial activism? And if we are, whose fault is it really? So, Anshu, before the break, you were talking about, you know, if one institution transgresses into the other, takes the other's role, then its own credibility also gets damned. But certain cases, certain judgments, if we can discuss some specifics.
Yeah, yeah. Sabrimala.
Yeah, Sabrimala.
Sabrimala, to my reading of the Constitution, right to equality vis-a-vis sex, caste, creed and religion related to the state. That in the eyes of the state, you shall not be discriminated on these grounds. We have extended this definition and said women will enter. Okay. But then it can't be selective. Now, as I said, the consequences of a judgment must always be visualized and understood, because these judgments have to bear with the test of time. And time span of not 1 year, 2 years, for centuries. What are we saying? Are we saying that Hazrat Bal, women will enter and see the Hazrat Sahab ka baal? Are we saying that Haji, which is an exclusive domain of the men, now you'll have women Hajis? You will have in the church, you will have nuns presiding? I mean, equality.
Temples also.
I mean, as I said, it can't be selectively decided. If this is an equality, then it is an equality across the country for the entire nation. It can't be selective to a particular religion.
Well, any priest in Kashi Vishwanath.
That's what this judgment means. This judgment should mean this.
Church intervened in the worldly affairs.
Hmm.
It was objected. And now if the secular court is going to interfere with the religious sentiments of people, one way or the other, the religion is going to protest.
Yeah.
I argued a case where the question was whether unshorn hair is an essential condition of Sikhism.
Hmm.
And when I argued that for me, what is essential for Sikhism has been decided by Guru Gobind Singh. And whatever the court may say, I and many other people would prefer to have to abide by the dictate of Guru Gobind Singh, that this is essential. So the question is, religious affairs, you can't test it on reason, you can't test it on proof of history. It is faith. People's faith, and you must respect that faith, and it should not be trampled upon by the courts.
And that is the reason why democracy provided for the people's representative to decide. I shall be governed by rules and laws made by me through my representatives. That is a basic dictum of the democracy.
But then what are the
you are today saying I shall legislate? Who? Not the people. But some other forum shall legislate. Is this what you're going to think democracy will last?
Okay, one no.
As legislators are abdicating.
Correct that. Every 5 years, people get an opportunity of correcting that mistake.
They corrected by throwing the Congress out,
so
by
fine.
Bringing the BJP in. Now, how many times will they keep correcting?
Sir, if we fail, people will change us. But at least there is a remedy.
Yes.
Okay,
what about somebody who has no, there is no remedy to?
Dinesh ji.
I have been in public life for a very long time now.
Hmm.
So has been.
You're a young man. How long could you be?
So, yeah,
that's
I'm
another
still
debate.
Very young.
Looks are deceptive.
Looking also is a very important aspect of life. But I have full faith in our constitution.
Absolutely.
And the framers of our constitutions were all big brains of this country, and we all remember their, you know, names. All of them.
Hmm.
All of them. So Parliament is supreme in its own domain, and so are the courts. And wherever there is a disbalance, I think the Parliament also come into being and say, look here, this is our area. Supreme Court also does. But my point is very simple. If we are supposed to take a decision in the political arena as a member of the society, and if we don't do it, then it cannot be left in a limbo. Ayodhya, again, I'm telling, if all the interested party go to the Supreme Court and say that, look here, my lord, we have decided to withdraw this case and we will have an amicable settlement. Supreme Court will be very happy. But what do we say
it's
now?
It's a self-defeating argument.
I never interrupted.
This adjudication is in court.
Let me finish. What do we say? All of us put together. Whatever Supreme Court says, we are all okay with that. We all say no.
Because
we can't decide. And we have equal respect. As far as I'm concerned, I have a lot of respect, and I'm sure everybody has a respect.
Okay, we are failing.
The Sabarimala, I think, should the court have taken a decision on something like that?
I do not think, first of all, what little I gathered about the temple, it's a private temple. It's not a government temple, first. Secondly, it is a belief for so many centuries that women shall not enter. I have nothing against the feminists who fought in this case and who wanted that women should be able to enter. It's very good. It is, they are citizens as much as I am a citizen. They have every right. But there is also the other aspect. How can a court sit on judgment on an issue which is emotional more than anything else, and emotions that are attached to beliefs, religious, social, whatever, for centuries together? How can 2-3 people who have probably themselves not even gone to that temple even once, sit here in Delhi in one domed building and say, this is what is to happen? Why should people respect? See, what has happened is, in India, since we've always had foreign rulers and they are the ones who impose the laws on us, over centuries with foreign rulers, we have come to know that the law is against us. The law is against me because the law is being created by a foreigner. So he's an alien to me. And anything he forms, anything he creates is to suppress me. And therefore, I want to oppose the law. If you tell me to drive on the left in Delhi, if you are driving, if you are seeing, everybody is driving on the middle of the street. It is because it is innate in us that we will oppose the law. Now, the Supreme Court comes into picture after 1947. They have lately started taking steps where they are saying, do this, do that, wash your face on the left side first in the morning, then go wash your hand on the right side in the evening. They start dictating your beliefs, your conformities for centuries which you have ingrained in your DNA. Suddenly they come up with that. What is happening? Now again they look alien to me. They must be looking alien to all those people who go to Sabarimala for years together. They must be looking alien to all the people in Puri where Jagannath temple, the Supreme Court is saying how the rit will be done, how the process will be conducted. What nonsense is this? How can they do that? Why should they get into it? They should opt out. They should opt out.
What exactly?
See, sir, mereko to it brings me to a more fundamental. What happens to my right to religion? And what is my religion? Is it going to be codified by somebody of this kind?
Absolutely.
I have a right to religion. I have a right to beliefs. I have to right to what I think. Is tomorrow you say there is no empirical evidence of God, so there is no religion? I mean,
at the same time, in the name of religion, you cannot do something which is against the law. When you say that my religion says that every day you cane 5 people, now that is not on. So we are all responsible. I think we are all responsible.
Supreme Court
we are all
a
responsible.
Police officer we are all, who was in the area during a lynching
we
process.
I think we are digressing from what we are talking.
Yeah, at least
I think we are all very responsible citizens, and we must understand that there is a rule of law. as long as we abide by the rule of law, it's
sir,
okay.
The rule of law is to be framed by the ruler, framers
I
of law.
I want to say this.
And not by people
see,
who are not
okay.
charged.
The law has to be in synchronicity with people's lifestyle. If it is
with
opposing people's lifestyle.
Yeah, but unfortunately, everybody is bypassing
the
constitutional
provisions. I think I'm going to. We're totally out of time, so last word to
last word
can, I say this that we are very proud of our judiciary?
Sure.
It's one of the best in the world. We are only talking about a certain policy. The
certain
Supreme Court needs to reconsider as to whether this unbridled entertainment of PILs at the cost of other adjudicatory functions is okay. We are only respectfully submitting to the Supreme Court.
Okay. On that note, I think we did have some sort of agreement, I think, which we were heading towards. But I think at the end of the day, I'll leave it at that now. Thank you for watching this show. We'll see you again same time next week.